Another question, sir, from Sam Medinilla. Given the latest inflation data, what are the new inflation and GDP growth rate projections of the government for this year?
The to be accurate, the inflation targets or forecasts are done by the DSP, not by the national government. And we estimate that inflation will remain elevated for the next few months, so that the annual average inflation for this year will be in the neighborhood of 5%. It will be down to 4.2% next year. That's the average inflation, and it will be back to the range, our target range of 2.2 to 4%. It will be back to 3.3% by 2024. Okay, this is a problem faced by many countries. You cannot cut inflation overnight. It has to be gradual, and so that's the forecast of the BSP. Okay,
thank you.
So it's 5, 4.2, and 3.3.
Thank you, Secretary. Next, from Neil Mercado of Inquirer.net. His question po, Aya, how much of a concern is limited fiscal space?
When you talk of fiscal space, you talk of the size of the deficit, okay? Size of the deficit. I think we still have a lot of fiscal space because we are confident that our revenues will pick up. In fact, yesterday we submitted what is called the medium-term fiscal consolidation framework. Okay. Fiscal, medium-term fiscal framework. That is from 2023 to 2028. That's the six-year term of the president. This is presented for the first time. Okay. So we want to show the world that we are conscious of having a sound fiscal management. So among the targets in that framework are the following. We expect the economy to grow by 6.5 to 7.5 this year. In fact, this is going to be the highest, the consensus is this will be the highest growth rate among all ASEAN plus three countries this year and next year. Okay? That's the consensus. When I say ASEAN plus three, that plus three means Japan, South Korea, and China. Okay? So the Philippines is expected to have the highest growth rate for the next 2 years. Yeah. And then it will be followed by a growth rate of 6.5 to 8% from year 2023 to year 2028. Now, we're not only concerned with growth per se, we're also concerned with reducing poverty. Okay? So our target is that by the end of President Marcos's term, poverty incidence will be down to single digit, 9%. Okay. If I remember right, it started at around 25% during the Duterte's first year in office. But we were almost down to around 18-17%. Then the pandemic hit us. Okay. So that there's a slight backsliding. But our target under this framework is that poverty rate will be down to 9% by 2028. Our target on the national government deficit to GDP ratio will be 3% starting 2026, 27, 28. Okay. Now on the debt, national debt, and you keep harping on this, 60%, that's the target. It will be down to 60% by 2025. Okay, right now it's around 63%. So it will be slowly tapering off to 60% by 2025. And that on the build program, we are committed to spend some 5 to 6% of GDP for infrastructure annually between 2023 to 2028. Okay, as you know, during the last 50 years before Duterte, the spending on infrastructure was only less than 2%. And finally, we want to achieve what is called an upper middle income status. So that means that we are shooting for a $4,046 per capita income for Filipinos by the end of the president's term. So those are the main target of this medium-term fiscal framework. I cannot talk in more details because this is supposed to be the president's, he will present this during his SONA. And there he will spell out the specifics on this. Okay.
Secretary, maybe it's the same, pero another question from Gil Mercado. When do you plan to release your fiscal consolidation plan?
Well, we have discussed it yesterday in the cabinet, and it was approved. This framework, as I said, will set the tone, or will be our say game plan for the next 6 years. And as I said, this is the first time that this government or any government of the Philippines has presented such a game plan. Okay, so we're not only thinking of a one-year plan, but it's a six-year plan on the budget. And the desire is to reduce the deficit, which ballooned during the pandemic, to around 9% deficit to GDP ratio to around 3% by 2025 or 2026.
Okay, Secretary, ang susunod pong magtatanong ay si Letner Siso ng DZRH. Ang tanong po niya, Secretary, sinabi ni PBBM na hahanapan ng pondo para maipagpatuloy ang subsidy sa transport sector. Mayroon na po bang tinitingnan o pinag-aaralan ng gobyerno kung saan maaaring kumuha ng dagdag pondo para magamit dito?
Meron ng pagkukunan. Yung sinabi ko kanina, yung windfall tax. Kasi because nakaset naman yung value, yung specific tax on petroleum products, since tumaas yung presyo ng gasolina in the world market, tapos nag-depreciate ng konti yung peso, so the peso value of our imports has increased, so magkakaroon tayo ng additional revenue as a result of that. No? Doon natin kukunin yun. Yung pagtaas ng presyo ng gasolina, ibabalik natin sa taong bayan in the form of targeted subsidy. Hindi lahat makakakuha, but yung mga mas apektado, sila makakakuha nito.
Okay. Secretary, may tentative na raw po kaya kung magkano ito?
Hindi, papatuloy lang natin yung 6,500 kasi mag-expire na yun itong June. Eh. So yung sinabi nila, this will be completed by the first week of July, yung pa yung kay President Duterte. So we will continue. Okay?
Okay. Ang susunod pong magtatanong ay si Rex Remisor ng CNN Philippines.
Hi, Sec. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Clarify ko lang, no? So, diba tinigil yung libreng sakay sa MRT? Was it too much ba for government coffers to subsidize MRT free rides?
Hindi ko alam na tinigil na ba yan?
Yes, according.
Since when?
July 1.
Okay. Hindi ko alam kung magkano nawala dun sa atin, but I know that we have rehabilitated MRT, as you know, on schedule na siya ngayon, di ba? Hindi nasisira, on schedule, and then siguro dapat naman magbayad na yung taong bayan dun. But meron siyang pinaplano ngayon na if you're a student, lilibre na ata yung, kaya lang LRT 2 ata yun, ano? But maybe we might consider it also for the whole mass transit system. I don't have the estimate right now. Pero malaking improvement na yung MRT, I know. No, nakikita ko talagang regular na yung pagdating niya. Tsaka mas madami na siyang karo ngayon, di ba? Hindi na siya nasisira. Okay?
Okay, salamat, Secretary Jokno. At ngayon naman po mga katanungan para kay Secretary Angeles Maricel Halili ng TV5.
Okay, sa'yo. Tapos na ako?
Hello, sir. Kyle Atienzo of Business World here, sir. Sir, my question will be, sir, will the DOF push for the completion of the comprehensive tax reform program? Is a taxation of profitable digital transactions outside the tax net among the priorities of the new admin? And what sectors will benefit the most from the new fiscal plan, sir?
Yung tax on digital services, I think it's only fair na dapat itatax natin yun, hindi ba? Kasi kung if you were going to buy it from the regular stores, nagtatax ka, eh bakit naman pagka digital, hindi ka magtatax, no? Di ba? I think in the sense of fairness, dapat magkaroon ng tax, especially medyo if you really think about it, yung mga nakakaangat ang sila nakakakuha ng mga ganyan digital payment. So in the on the basis of fairness, I think they should be taxed. Now on the remaining parts of the comprehensive tax reform program na pinus ng Duterte administration, there are two remaining packages. I think ang estimate noon is that it's supposed to be revenue neutral, no? Walang additional revenues na makukuha doon, but it will simplify a lot the tax system. So we will push for that, and then we expect that to be approved before the end of the year, and it will be implemented next year.
Sir, last question, sir. How to cut government spending? Is the DOF considering a shift to PPP, sir? Is it supporting a shift to PPP, sir? Public-private partnerships?
PPP.
In terms of infra development, sir?
Oh, we will push for PPP. Okay. Kaya naman hindi siya na-push nung time ni Duterte is that when we came in, I'm talking of President Duterte, walang available na mga projects na ready for implementation. Now we are able to develop some 88 or 89 major projects ready to go, shovel ready na yun. So if there are some private sector interest, we will welcome that. No? And also because we recently approved yung tinatawag na Public Services Act, which means 100% control of foreigners of some industry like telco, tollways, shipping, etc. I think we encourage them to come in, okay, and maybe choose some of those projects or develop their own, and we will welcome the PPP arrangement, not only at the national level, but also at the local level. I see there are some local governments, some cities, who have the money to enter into this kind of arrangement. This will help us reduce the, rather enlarge yung tinatawag na fiscal space. So sa salip na 100% na gastos ng gobyerno, I think only a fraction of thereof will be spent by the government for projects that will benefit the Filipino people. Okay? Yes.
Sir, on power hike lang po, mayroon pong Supreme Court ruling allowing Meralco to implement a staggered power rate hike. Napag-usapan po ba ito sa during cabinet meeting or sa meeting ni PBBM with the economic team? Ano po kanya naging directives? What are the measures to be implemented by the government para naman po maibsan yung mga burden na hinaharap ngayon ng mga consumers?
Okay, I'll be frank with you. Wala ako sa cabinet meeting kahapon. Okay? So, absent ako. So, hindi ko alam po. Hindi pinag-usapan yun. Hindi pinag-usapan yun.
How about, sir, sa economic team? Ano yung magiging
hindi
plan
nyo? Hindi namin napag-usapan. But I think kailangan yung manggagaling ang dapat siguro sa Department of Energy. Unfortunately, wala pa kaming Secretary for Energy. Okay? So, hindi napag-usapan yan. Okay?
So. Okay, just to wrap up, Alexis Romero of PhilStar.
Clarification for Secretary. No? Yung 6.5 to 7.5 growth, it's also for 2023?
For 2023, mas mataas pa, 6.5 to 8%.
Okay.
Mas ambisyoso kami kasi maraming bagong reforma eh.
Mas
I think
optimism.
we can So yung 6.5 to 7.5 this year, palagay ko medyo conservative pa nga yun eh. Remember, the first quarter is 13.2, no? Second quarter I would think will be even higher than the 13.2. Why? Because remember, nagkaroon tayo ng surge nung January 2002, eh, di ba? 2022 pala. Nagkaroon tayo ng surge sa COVID. Eh. So, 2 months lang yun, yung 13.2. So, mas malakas pa yung, I guess, no? As a former governor of the central bank, ang forecast ko mga around.
Sec, dahil nabanggit niya na rin yung surge, no? Yung economic team ba, will they be adapting the same stance nung Duterte government na hindi na tayo mag-wide-reaching lockdowns?
I think no country now will, except maybe China, will go into general lockdowns. No? Talagang focused. And I think we have now graduated from being pandemic to endemic. We have to live with the virus. And kasi most of us are vaccinated anyway, right? Some of our even have boosters, no? Third and fourth booster.
So the economic team does not prefer yung general.
In fact, that is also key to the 100% opening of the or face-to-face opening of classes. No? The plan is it will start opening up by August, and then 100% by November.
Thank you, Sec.
Thank you so much, Secretary Jok. No, now we go back to Maricel Halili for Secretary.
Okay, thanks. Thank you, sir.